Good afternoon, student. So in this particular class, today I am going to show you that how you can create the different types of the data, and as we can create the different pattern of the queries, okay, SQL queries, different type of SQL queries. So those the different pattern of SQL queries that how we will use the query functions. The query function is very important. In class 11 we have done different pattern of functions, and we have used the different type of queries. So you see here there are the four tables we have taken. Okay, so this is the four table. One is inventory, one is customer, one is sale, one is employee. Under those four table you can see card ID, card name, price, model, year of manufacture, customer ID, customer name, customer address, phone number, email, then employee ID, employee name, date of birth, the date of joining, designation, salary. So all these things are there. So here what we see, here what we can find, that when we are using those pattern of tables, those tables, that means each and every table there we do have what we will going to have the different type of values has been inserted. See, inventory table is there, inventory table has been inserted. After that we have a customer table, and then we have a sales table. So all this particular, and the employee table. So all this table, what we will going to do at this particular moment, we will first create the single row function query, single row function query, and then we will see that how those queries are been implemented in a table. Okay, so single row function query, today's topic that we will going to select is a numerical function, numeric functions. So numeric function means row, that means round, power, and mode function is there. Okay, round, power, and mode function is there. So in those the function today we will see about the power function and round function, and the mode function also we will see, an implementation of the power function in a table. So let us first see the particular thing. See here, there are the power function. Power means what? Power x, y. So when we calculate those power, we can see that this the power what we have, this is the power that we find, that we will going to have those power sections, and we are using those power sections, isn't it? So since we are using those power sections, we can find it, we can see it, that how the power is being implemented, how we can make the power implement. So select power, then we will going to use that particular, the 2, 3, what is the power. Next what we see, round function. Round is the two type. Round, how many place value we want to round off, that we will see, that if you give (1), then 1 place value, 2 place value. And next what we see, we can make the round off in the any place. And the next what we can find, the mod function. Mod means to find out the remainder. Okay, if you want to find out the remainder, so we will use the mod. So let us see those things, let us see those part. Okay, that how we can implement it in the SQL. So let us see it. So now you see, I have opened here the SQL or the structured query language. So in this structured query language, as I have shown you, those the tables are there or not. So how to bring it? First we will go inside the database and see, we will see that what are the tables. First we do show, SHOW, show databases, tables, TABLES, tables. So those are the tables, you see it, and that they are existed here. Okay, what are they? They are the employee table, inventory table, and student one table. So it is under what? It is under the student details. Fine. So they are under the student details. So this is what we can see, this is what we can find, that we have those the particular table, and we can create the different type of queries, and those the functional queries that we will going to see, that will be implemented here. Okay, so those the functional query, we find it, we will going to see it here. we can implement those query and we can use those query. So as we are using them, as we are implementing them, so each and every part of this implementation, now say let us see the command first. Okay, so there are the what numerical command we have learned. So let us write that. Okay, so the first command that we will going to use is a power command. Okay, select power function, select power, power 5,2. If you give 5,2, what it will be? See here, the work is 5 to the power of 2, 5 is a base and this will be the power. So 5 to the power of 2 is what? It will be 25, 5, 5 is 25. So similarly, if you again write 5,2, now let us change it, let us make it, suppose we are making it 9, and here we are making the thing suppose 12. Okay, so as we are making these things, as we see it, see here, this the power has came here. So as we find it, as we can see those power value, the power value is in this way will going to be calculated, right? So as we give the power value, as we find the power value is there, we can calculate the power in a different way or in a different manner. So those the power that we have, those the power that we can find, that we are using different pattern of power. Now another power value you see, select power 8,10, 8 to the power of 10. So 8 to the power of 10, what we will see, see here, this is the particular thing, that means 8 to the power of 10, this the value will going to be implemented. Okay, so as we find it, as we see it, that those the different sections, those the different part and different sections that we have, and we are implementing, and we are using. So when we are implementing it, and when we are using it, so each of this particular implementation, each of this particular implementation of the power, we can make them, and we can have it. Okay, we can make it. Next, what we say, next we have next function, that is called a round function. So round function, the different pattern of round functions that we have. Suppose we have taken the value, this is the value, isn't it? This is the particular value we have taken, and in this particular value what we can see, that we have those the particular number 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 8, 2, 5, 6. So 256,3. So when we make it, when we find it, you see it here, as we give enter, you see this round function has implemented. Okay, this round function has came. So as the round function is working here, as we find it, that we have the round functions there, that means 3 place it will going to take. After decimal point, the 3 place will going to be taken by it. Okay, after decimal point, the 3 place will be going to taken by it. After that, suppose now I, if I increase it, if I increase it, suppose 6, 8, 8, 8, then we are giving here 3. Then if you write it, say that 6, 2, 5, 6. Now 6 has been implemented as and it has increased as per the mathematical rule that we have read. As per the mathematical rule, it has increased by what? It has increased by 1. So 6 has now became the 7 because there is 8 here. Okay, so there is an 8, and therefore we have written that one, and now we see it, now we can find it. The another functions, that another implementation of the functions that we have. See here, another value I have taken, that is the value 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 8 0.256635, up to the fifth decimal position. So if I do up to the fifth decimal position, what it will be? See, when I make it up to the fifth decimal position, that means 5 place, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that means up to here, this 3 has been increased, and 3 has become now what? 3 has become now 4. Okay, 3 has become now 4. Why? Because there is this particular 5 is there. Let us do another one. Let us make another particular value, make it as a suppose 6 decimal place, and let us increase them. Okay, let us increase that. Suppose 9, 9, 9, and there also we make it this one as 7. Some increment, some changes we have done. So when we have done those changes, what we can find, if you give enter, you see here up to the 6th place it will going to take. That means which is your 6th place? Your 6th place is up to this much. So when it will take up to this much, that means from this particular criteria, from this particular area, it will going to make the data and it will going to use those data in this particular way, okay, in this particular manner. So when it use the data in this particular manner, when it use the data in this particular form, so we are making them and we are using them some of the particular formations, some of the particular way that we have and we have completed it. Okay, so this is how we can implement the round function, different round functions that we have and round functions that we are creating. So each of these particular functions that we are doing and that we are creating the function. So in this way we can make the round functions. Okay, so this is what, this is a single implementation we are seeing at this moment. After the round functions, then let us see the functions that is known as a mode functions. Okay, so mode functions that we have, the mode functions that we will going to use, see here, mode functions or mode functions. So mode functions, what we can find, say suppose 4 comma 2, mode means what? Divider. That means when we divide it, what the remainder we will going to get from there. What the reminder we will get going to get from here. So as we see it, as we find it, that as we are doing this particular structure, as we are making up those particular structures, so each and every structure that we have and that we are declaring, 4 divided by 2 means what? 0. Okay, now next what we can find, that 15, now we have taken 15 divided by 2, so select mod, then bracket open, 15 comma 2. So this is what, 15 divided by 2, see 15 divided by 2 is 1, that means we are getting here 1 from there, from this particular mod function implementations. Okay, so when we are having those mod function implementation, when we find that we have those mod function implementation, so here are the mod functions that we have. Let us write another one, NCLECT, select, then open the bracket, that sorry, select, then what, mod, 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 then open the bracket. After opening the bracket, then gives some value, suppose 58 comma 6. Now you, okay, then semicolon, close the bracket, semicolon, because we know according to the Bodmer's theorem we have to close the bracket and we have to give the semicolon of it. So mod 58 comma 6 means we are doing this particular portion and we are making this particular portion to be implemented. So when we give it, see here that this is the particular thing that we have and we are implementing it, isn't it? So this is the way that we find that we have those implementation of the different mod functions. Okay, we have those implementations of the different mod functions. So in this manner or in this particular scenario, we can find, we can see that those the mod functions are being executed, those the mod functions are being implemented. So what we have written, select mod, then bracket open, then we will going to have going to have those particular pattern or those particular function to be implemented. Okay, now when we find it, when we see it, that we are having those particular structure to be implemented. Now you see here, now you find it, and that another mod functions we can give and we can implement of it. So different pattern of mod functions can be used and different type of mod functions can be implemented in this particular structure of implementation. That means what the remainder we need to see. Let us see another one, suppose SELECT. Select, if you want to do round, then ROUND, round, then you can open it, and then you have to write round of what, suppose 56342.571. Okay, 8. Then how many decimal place? Suppose I want to give now 1 decimal place. So 1 decimal place and then semicolon. You see here, this is the round of figure it is going to come. Okay, so this is the round of figure that it will going to show to us. Now, if you want to do the mod function, so ACLECT select, then MOD mod. After giving the mod, then what we will do, we will open a bracket. We will make one bracket here to be open. Mod of what? If you divide something, suppose 457, comma, divided by suppose 5. So, close it, semicolon, enter. So, see here, the remainder is 2. That means what we see, what we can find, that when we are implementing those things, when we are implementing those the different type of functions that we have learned just now, we have seen just now. So, what are the functions we have learned basically? We have learned about the round function, mod functions that we are using, isn't it? And as we are using the mod functions, we are using the round functions, those the values that we are seeing from here, that we find it, that this the particular value that we have, and we are implementing. And another, that we have a power function, that we have seen power of a value that to be implemented. So SELECT select, POWER power. What power we want to select, what power we want to see, the power of what, power of suppose we want to give 56 comma to the power of 8. So when we give this thing, when we find this thing, we can see it, we can find it, and that we will going to have those the values. See here, the power value has been implemented in this way or in this area. Okay, so this is how we can see, this is how we can find, that when we are having those the different pattern of functions, we can see that how they are being implemented and how they are being utilized. Okay, now we have seen those things, we have seen those things. Now let us think about the GST is being calculated. Okay, so GST has been calculated, we want to calculate the GST, so we require a table. So what we will do, first SHOW show, TABLES, show tables. So as we do show tables, enter, say there are the 3 tables. So GST generally in which table we will going to see? Inventory. Okay, so let us see the structure of it. So DESC INVENTORY, inventory. So describe the inventory. See, this is the structure of a table. We have a card ID, we have, which is a VATCAD pattern, which card name is also VATCAD pattern, price is a decimal, model is a VATCAD pattern, year of manufacture is a date pattern, and fuel is a VATCAD pattern. So this is the thing that we can see that we do have, and we are implementing it in this particular area. Okay, so when we are implementing in this particular area, because this table has been created earlier by us. So let us see the inside value. So ACLECT select, then asterisk FROM from inventory, 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 select asterisk from inventory. When we do so, see here, those the values are there, that means price is there, and base this price, based on the price we have to calculate one GST. Okay, based on the price we have to calculate the GST. So how to do it, what will be then the question of it, let us see the question, let us find what the question is there, then we will going to do that particular work. So see here, See here, this is the particular area that we have. This is the particular area that we do find and we are implementing, isn't it? So we are implementing the pattern and we are using those things. That means we are using those patterns. See here that GST to be calculated. GST to be calculated based on what? Based on the price of the car. That means the price of the car, based on that we need to create the GST. That means here till now what we have seen, till now those the things that we have seen, we are implementing them where? We are implementing them in a different section, in a separate way. Separately we are implementing them. Now this the implementation that we are doing, we are implementing it in a way or in a part that we can find that we are implementing in the table. That means now we those the function, one first function that we will see today only, that one function how we are implementing in the table. Okay, so when we find it that we are implementing those the function in a table, when we find that we are implementing those function in a table, so how to implement them and how to work with them. Okay, how to implement them and how to work with them. So implementing what? Select round, then how many percent? 12%, then 100 into price, comma 1. 1 means from the decimal point how many place? 1 place. Then this is the name has been given from inventory. So let us see that how we can do it and how we can organize this particular structures. Okay, how we can organize this particular structure. So let us make this one to be implementable. This has make this one to be applicable. So when we see it, let us see the command. What we say that it is already I have written it earlier for you so that you can understand it. Select round that 12 slash 100, 12 slash 100 means 12 by 100 into price. This is the price, these are the price. Then comma, how many place? 1 place. Okay, 1 place it has been taken, and as it has been taken 1 place, then we can see that what a GST of the car. GST of the car, that is the tag or the name of a column that has been given from where? From inventory. So when we do this, when we find this particular thing, when we see it that this the particular thing has been given, you can see here that we have those the data and we are creating those data for the purposes and for the different pattern of the work that we do implement and that we do use it. Okay, so when we are using it, when we are making the particular pattern, so each and every pattern, each and every structure that we have, see here that 12% price has been calculated, and when this 12% price has been calculated, those are the different values that we can see that we do have it here, isn't it? We do have it here. So this is the way, this is the pattern that we can find that we have, and we have implemented those pattern in this particular way or in this particular manner. Okay, so in this particular manner means see here what select round, then price we say that what is the price that we have in the table, those the price columns. Okay, those the value will be taken, those the values what is there, each and every value will be taken. So when each and every value will be taken, we can meet it, and we can see it that round of we are making to it, we are making the round of figure of it. And as we are making the round of, that means as we are making the round of what? The price that will be got. So if you calculate it in a calculator, you will find those the values are coming after this will come 0.56. So that 5 has been increased and became 6. So similarly that 77743 point it will come 96. Okay, so 96 means 9 will be now increased by 10. As it increased by 10, that means the before value will going to be increased. So this is the way we can see, this is the way we can find that how we can make those the value to be increased and how they are being implemented in a different area. okay, how they are implemented in a different area. So this is the implementation, this is the type of implementations we do have, and we are calculating them, and we are implementing them in this particular structures, and we are making them in this particular scenario. Okay, so this is what we do have, this is what we define, that our values that we have made and we have implemented. So these are the sub functions implementations we have seen. What are they? They are the round functions, they are the power functions, and that is a mod functions. So we have used those functions, we have implemented those functions, and not only in a single way, we have implemented them in a table also. One function we have implemented, next coming classes I will show you how we can implement it in the other part and other table. So this is the way that we have seen how those the values are being implemented. Okay, and today I am ending my class here. Thank you all very much for attending the class. Thank you.